हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंस फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 75। व्हाट्सएप अनाउंस इट्स न्यू टर्म्स ऑफ सर्विस बैक इन जनवरी। दिस क्रिएटेड अ न्यू कंट्रोवर्सी बैक देन वेयर द यूजर्स वर सपोज्ड टू एक्सेप्ट न्यू टर्म्स ऑफ सर्विस और लीव द प्लेटफॉर्म। कंसिडरिंग द वाइड स्प्रेड क्रिटिसिज्म, द कंपनी पुश्ड द डेडलाइन ऑफ एक्सेप्टिंग द न्यू टर्म्स ऑफ सर्विस टिल May 15th। हाउएवर, यस्टरडे रिपोर्ट बाय PTV रिवील दैट व्हाट्सएप वोंट बी डिलीटिंग यूर अकाउंट इफ यू डोंट एक्सेप्ट द न्यू टर्म्स ऑफ सर्विस। द कंपनी मेंशन्ड ऑन इट्स ऑफिशियल वेबसाइट दैट यूजर्स कैन एक्सेप्ट टर्म्स ऑफ सर्विस आफ्टर May 15th एज वेल, बट देयर इज अ कैच। WhatsApp will continue to show them the notification asking them to accept new terms of service. The reminder will be shown to user for every several weeks once users see the persistent reminder. WhatsApp will limit some functionalities. In the limited functionality period, users won't be able to access their chat list. However, if users continue to receive a chat, they will be able to open it through their notification and also respond to them. In this period, users will also continue to receive audio and video calls. However, if a new terms of service is not accepted even after a week, users won't continue to receive any calls or messages. WhatsApp is soon expected to introduce a new feature which will allow people to easily transfer chats between Android and iOS devices. This feature will be the extension of multi-device support, which is also to reach WhatsApp users soon. As revealed by WhatsApp Beta Info, the messaging app new beta version 2.21 gives us an idea as to what capabilities the feature will get. It is suggested that apart from the easy transfer of WhatsApp chats between two devices, WhatsApp will also sync them. This means that two chats on two different phones with the same WhatsApp account will be kept in sync for further ease of usage. This will also include pinned and start messages. However, if a chat deleted on one device is deleted, it won't reflect on the other. Unless the deletion happens for everyone, the sender and all the recipients. The shortage of medical oxygen in several parts of the country due to the second wave of COVID outbreak, the Hyderabad-based startup The Five Factory is aiming to save lives through its innovative and affordable portable oxygen generator. The co-founder of Five Factory, Praveen Gokarvi, said that Vayuputra has been developed with an objective to support the COVID-19 patients who are under home isolation. With emergency oxygen supply at a low capital expenditure during home isolation, in case of a patient oxygen saturation level drops, he or she is then admitted to the nearest hospital, but during this transmit, many people are losing their lives due to the lack of oxygen. This situation can be avoidable. He mentioned that oxygen cylinder and oxygen concentrators are available at a very higher rate in the current market and cannot be afforded by people. He felt that the product that is to be developed must be both economic at the same time life-saving, and that is when he came up with an idea of oxygen generator. The project Vayuputra asked about the capacity of oxygen generator. Gokarvi said that this oxygen generator consumes around 20 liters of hydrogen peroxide, that it can produce enough oxygen to last 12 hours. Explaining the working of the oxygen generator, Gokarvi said that when hydrogen peroxide comes in contact with the metal oxide, the decomposition reaction takes place and oxygen along with the water is derived. Using a catalyst bed made of a metal oxide fixed in a container, and when hydrogen peroxide passes through the catalytic bed, the reaction takes place and giving us oxygen alongside water. He said that the container contains three columns in order to filter all the water vapor and it produces oxygen. He further mentioned that oxygen generator uses 50% of concentrated hydrogen peroxide and said that 1 liter of such hydrogen peroxide would be able to produce around 240 liter of oxygen, which is enough for around 24 minutes. He said that oxygen generator is fixed with a 2 liter bottle of hydrogen peroxide, making it usable for 48 minutes per bottle. Oxygen generator kit would be given along with the 2 liters bottle of hydrogen peroxide. Instagram has announced that the company is aware that users worldwide faced an error when their post stories and even highlights got deleted mysteriously. The company and its chief Adam Mosseri said that the error caused by a bug has now been fixed. The timing of the glitch was unfortunate as many activists were trying to run an awareness campaign about missing indigenous women. Instagram said that the technical issues did not pertain to any topic or locations and users globally appear to be impacted. Though the company does not mention India, many activists in the country complained of similar errors while resharing COVID-19 related resources on Instagram. It remains unclear whether so-called bug affected Indian users as well.
Pandemics gives boost as more states move to digital IDs. Industry leaders safeguards will prevent anyone's information from being stolen, but some critics argue that having so much personal data on a phone is too risky. The card that millions of people use to prove their identity to everyone from police officer to liquor store owners may soon be a thing of the past as growing number of states develop digital driver license. With the advent of digital wallets on onboarding passes, people are relying more on their phones to prove their identity. At least 5 states have been implemented a mobile driver license program. 3 others like Utah, Iowa, and Florida intend to launch programs by next year, with more expected to follow suit. Nokia mobile brand license HMD Global has released the revised Android 11 roadmap of its smartphones. The roadmap includes a total of 18 devices that would receive the Android 11 OS update by the end of the third quarter this year. In the first quarter of 2021, 8 smartphones like Nokia 3.2, 8.3, 4.2, 8.1, 2.2 and 3.2 receive the software updates. Smartphones such as OnePlus 1.3 and 5.3 and 5.4, 3.4, 6.2 and Nokia V8 5G UW should be getting the update in this quarter. On the other hand, Nokia 1.4 and Nokia 2.3 already received Android 11 in the second quarter, that is in April. Realme launched the Realme Narzo 30 series devices, Realme Narzo 30A and Realme Narzo 30 Pro a couple of months back in India. The brand didn't launch the vanilla Narzo 30 and it said that it will be launched in the future. Realme has officially confirmed the launch date of upcoming Narzo 30 smartphone. The device will launch on May 18th in Malaysia. An YouTuber posted the unboxing video of the devices. The YouTuber also revealed the key specification of the device. Narzo 30 will feature a 6.5-inch Full HDPS LCD display with 90Hz refresh rate. And the big change compared to the predecessor is since Narzo 20 comes with a HDPS display. It will pack an octa-core MediaTek Helio G95 processor. This is the same processor that powers some of the popular mid-range devices such as. And the smartphone will have a 6GB RAM variant. We can expect the company to launch a 4GB variant as well. The Narzo 30 will be the first Narzo series device to boot Realme UI 2.0 based on Android 11. The Narzo 30 will feature a 48MP triple rear camera. The primary sensor of the smartphone will be accompanied by a 2MP macro and a 2MP of black and white lens. The smartphone will offer a 16MP front selfie shooter housed based on punch hole on the top left of the corner. Narzo 30 will be equipped with a 5000mAh battery with 30W fast charging support. It will have a 3.5mm audio jack and a USB Type-C charging port. Unisoft has announced some major plans to expand its universe of its Tom Clancy's The Division franchise. Among the many things the publisher announced, it noted that there will be a mobile version of the game launching sometime in the future. However, that's all a Ubisoft revealed about the game. It is noted that it will provide an additional details about the mobile game at a later date. While nothing has been confirmed yet, one can speculate that the game of the mobile version will not deviate too far from the one we can see PC and consoles. Just like what we see with PUBG Mobile and a Call of Duty Mobile.
Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.